My husband announced that he was running for President of the United States. And what did I do to celebrate? The same thing that all of you probably did. I went to work.
Jill Biden went right back to her job as a professor after her husband, former Vice President Joe Biden, announced his presidential bid. The 2020 race is her 14th time campaigning for her husband, Joe, or late son, Beau. She writes about some of those races and becoming a Biden in her new book, Where the Light Enters, Building a Family, Discovering Myself. Jill Biden, good morning.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here.
Thank you.
14 campaigns. Oh, my gosh.
Yes, that's a lot. Yeah. Now I'm a veteran at it.
Yeah. Yeah. So why will 2020 be exactly like the previous ones, or why will it be different?
I think it'll be a little bit different. You know, so many people have come to us and said, Joe's got to run, Joe's got to run. And we just decided maybe this was his time. And I think we need to bring the country together, unite people, and I think that's Joe's strength, and that's why America needs Joe Biden.
You know, people say, you got to run, you got to run, and one of the things you have to do as a politician is check yourself and say, wait a minute, running is hard and it's brutal.
Oh, it is.
And President Trump has shown that he likes to get involved in a fist fight. Are you on for that? Are you ready for a full campaign of that?
Well, you know, our family has been through a lot of campaigns. We're, I think, pretty resilient. The children and our grandchildren are used to campaigning. And when we decided we thought we were going to do this, we called all the grandkids. All five of them came. We sat in the library and said, what do you think? Pop's thinking about this. And to a child, they said, Pop has to run. He has to do this. And they were really positive about it. So they're going to be out there working hard for him.
And what about you? You write in the book, which I have to say surprised me, page 99, you were never a natural political spouse, you said.
No.
You were never as confident as you appeared. Mm-hmm. And as John points out, campaign now number 14. Do you feel ready and up for it? Clearly you do because you're doing it.
Yes.
But what did it take for you to get there?
Well, you know, I think by nature I'm more shy, I'm more introverted, and once I married Joe, I realized that I had to just reach out to people a little bit. I think they took my shyness as maybe a little arrogant, and I saw that, and I thought, I've got to get better at this. And it's just like speaking, public speaking. I really was very nervous. I wrote about it in my book.
Yeah.
And so, you know, you have to push yourself to be better, do better.
And you intend to continue teaching.
Well, today I'm giving finals, or I'm, you know,
covering. You're with us.
I was told there wouldn't be a test.
Yeah. So my students are taking finals right now as we speak.
I spoke to you in 2016 for 60 Minutes, and you decided then not to run, and Beau had just passed. And the vice president said at the time he didn't think he could win. That's why he didn't run. What's changed?
You know, after Beau died, we knew we couldn't put our heart and our soul into running. And I think running for president is so hard, and you're traveling all the time, and you're meeting a lot of people. And you've got to have your head in the game 100% of the time. Mm-hmm. And Joe's ready to do that. We weren't ready. There's no way that anyone who lost a child could just jump into something like that.
Well, your husband will be 77 on Election Day. Some people are using the A word for age. Uh-huh. Should age be a factor in this particular race when it comes to him?
When it comes to him, no. I mean, he has more energy than anybody I know, but that's for the American people to decide.
Uh-huh.
So he's going to be out there. He's campaigning. He's already out there. And they'll see him. They'll see the energy, the passion, and his enthusiasm.
What concerns you most about the direction the country's going in?
Well, I think we're really divided now. There's so much division.
Do you blame the White House for that?
Well, it's partly, I think, the White House that has said it's us and them, and Joe's a convener. He brings people together, and that's who he is, and I think that's what this country really desperately needs.
You write in the book that your husband comes from a family of huggers, and
yes.
So that's gotten him into some trouble here early in the campaign. What's he learned from that experience?
Oh, he's learned that he needs to give people their space. Look, these women who have come forward, this woman in particular, you know, really was courageous. And I have said, I have been in a similar situation. It happened years and years ago. And at that time, I didn't say anything because women never used to say anything. Now they speak up. Now they have the courage to come forward. And I think that's a good thing. I think that's a good change. And Joe has heard that message.
Were you surprised that he was even accused of that? Because people who know Joe say, listen, he's a very handsy guy. He's a very affectionate guy. Were you surprised that his actions could have been misinterpreted?
Well, not in these times. Not in these times. So I think as, you know, maybe 10 years ago, people were just more accepting of, you know, connections or you know, putting your hand on someone's arm. But now, no, it's different. It's different in my classroom.
Yeah.
I mean, before you used to, you know, put your hand on a student or it's a shoulder or whatever. But now I'm very conscious of it. I don't touch anybody.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's a beautiful book. And
thank you.
I can't believe you were a rebellious teenager. Dr. Biden, who teaches English as a second language. There's lots of details about you as a teenager that I couldn't believe.
But before you go, there's more to come, I know. But have you given him suggestions on who he should choose as a running mate?
We've only just gotten into this.
I know, but we have to start thinking about this, Dr. Biden.
Well, let's see what you come up with.
Oh, I don't have any.
You can give some suggestions.
Yes, well, apparently the test is yours today.
Yes.
All right. Dr. Biden, thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you.